There's a few current projects. Some sound like they're from an episode of Star Trek. Consider a ship like the USS Theodore Roosevelt, hobbled last year when 1,271 crew members tested positive for the coronavirus. What if everyone on board had their health... Dr. Hepburn showed us a few current projects. Some sound like they're from an episode of Star Trek. Consider a ship like the USS Theodore Roosevelt, hobbled last year when 1,271 crew members tested positive for the coronavirus. What if everyone on board had their health monitored with this subdermal implant, now in late-stage testing? It's not some dreaded government microchip to track your every move, but a tissue-like gel engineered to continuously test your blood.
It's a sensor.
This tiny green thing in there?
That tiny green thing in there. You put it underneath your skin, and what that tells you is that there are chemical reactions going on inside the body, and that signal means you're going to have symptoms tomorrow.
Wow. There's an actual transmitter in that?
Yeah, it's like a check engine light.
Check this sailor out before he infects other people.
That's right.
Sailors would get the signal, then self-administer a blood draw and test themselves on sight.
Look at that.
We can have that information in 3 to 5 minutes. As you truncate that time, as you diagnose and treat, what you do is you stop the infection in its tracks.
This is the book of Ecclesiasticus, or the book of Sirach, chapter 12, verse 10. Never trust thine enemy, for like as iron rusteth, so is his wickedness. This is the book of Revelation, chapter 13, beginning at verse 14. Revelation, chapter 13, beginning at verse 13. And he doth great wonders, so that he make a fire come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men. Verse 14, and deceiveth them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles which he had power to do in the sight of the beast, saying to them that dwell on the earth that they should make an image to the beast which had the wound by a sword and did live. Verse 15, and he had power to give life unto the beast, Salakia, and he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. Verse 16, and he caused of all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their forehead. Verse 17, and that no man might buy or sell save he that had the mark or the name of the beast or the number of his name. I want to start off by giving all praises, honor, and glory to Kol Haloyim, La Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahwashai, Ba'ashem, Rachagodash Rakatam. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Ray Millstone, who rule well. Peace and salutations to the Akim across the four corners of the earth, pushing this truth with faith and sincerity, and risking their lives and freedom to do so. Shalom to the Akwath and the Akim out there listening and learning. Lord willingly, this is an edifying lesson. Shalom to the Israelite foreigners scattered abroad in the land of the other nations, appearing like the other nations, with subscribing to this truth. To you, I say shalom. This is Brother Yahweh Sapa of the GMS Cleveland Church, a fellow servant, coming into another lesson through the spirit and power of Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai. And right now, you know, came across this article, decided to do a video on it. I've been getting flagged about the stab and jab. I was just listening to the Brother Shapatya out of the Chicago camp, and it's the spirit, because he made a quick hit video talking about, you know, Esau, and basically how you got people that's not even going to touch certain topics, but our jobs as watchmen are to bring out information that, you know, they're trying to actually avoid or cover up. And that's how you should know that what time we're in, you know. Right now, I mean, literally, it talks about them inserting a chip. You know, this isn't like hearsay. This isn't conspiracy. I mean, you know, I just played the video. And, you know, the first thing they want to say is, you know, this isn't a government conspiracy. But, you know, how can you trust the same devil that has lied about so many different things? You know what I mean? Like, this man is a liar and a father of it. So, you know what I mean? At the end of the day, that's why I brought out that Ecclesiasticus was the rock. Never trust thine enemy, you know. This man said that we were only going to lock down for a couple of weeks, and then you were locked down for months, you know what I mean? So, at the end of the day, and that's how you know, scripture says, Yahweh Shai is going to come back as a thief in the night, you know what I mean? When people say peace and safety, then sudden destruction shall come, because at the end of the day, you got people, they're opening up all these different states and countries, and then you got countries locked down, you got countries locking back down. So it's inevitable that we lock back down again, because like I said, at the end of the day, they want people to, you know, it's actually, it seems to me like a mind game, you know what I mean? Because, you know, like, right now, you know, being that they got this vaccine created, and you got so many people partaking in it, which, you know, they could be lying about the numbers. At first, I thought that the numbers were more so correct, because you see a lot of people taking this shit. But at the end of the day, I'm listening to data and different numbers. You know, I'm heard that we were over 100 million. Now I'm hearing that we're close to 100 million. So, again, why would you trust this man? This man's a fucking liar. I done listened to maybe 4 or 5 different sources. They all said different numbers. You know what I mean? You look on the news, they talk about over 100 million vaccinated. You read a publication, they talk about 80 million. Hold up. How one source going to say one number? And then this is like clearly in your face. Just like it's clearly in your face that people are having adverse reactions to the point that the United States wanted to halt the J&J stab and jab, but yet and still, you still gonna have people that's willing to accept it, showing you how the Lord really has people blind, you know, blinded the minds of the people. So I'm gonna bring out some of this article. I thought of a few scriptures, the most significant ones. It's not a long article, and Lord willing, is edifying. It says, "Are you ready for a seed monitoring microchip to be implanted under your skin?" U.S. government scientists just revealed a new implantable chip that continuously monitors your body for CV. It says techstartups.com 3 days ago. Forget about CV vaccines. The U.S. government is working on futuristic technology that will continuously monitor your body for signs of CV before you even realize you had one. And it makes me think of Upgrade, you know what I mean? For whatever reason, that's just what keep popping up in my head. Yesterday, the Pentagon's Defense Advanced Research Project Agency revealed that it had developed an implantable chip that it says will continuously monitor the body for signs of the V. This is real and not some kind of conspiracy theory. On Sunday, retired Army Colonel Matt Hepburn, an Army infectious disease physician who worked for years with the Defense Advanced Research Project Agency, talked about the project in an interview on the CBS show 60 Minutes to demonstrate the technology. Holding up a vial of green tissue-like gel which contains the chip, Hepburn proclaimed, "You put it underneath your skin, and what that tells you is that there are chemical reactions going on inside the body, and that signal means you are going to have symptoms tomorrow." Hepburn showed off the implant to Bill Whitaker of CBS, who noted how the device could be used. Consider a ship like the USS Theodore Roosevelt, hobbled last year with 1,271 crew members tested positive for CV. What if everyone on board had their health monitored with the subdermal implant now in late-stage testing? Whitaker said, "It's not some dread government chip to track your every move, but a tissue-like gel engineered to continuously test your blood." And, you know, you can believe anything somebody say, but at the end of the day, you got to remember, technology is so far advanced now. You got, you know, like I said, your phone tracks can be tracked, you know what I mean, because of the GPS equipment that's being used. So it's, you know, it's components inside your phone that's actually being able to be tracked. Yeah, you can do other things with the phone. You know, I was listening to Chris Rock. Arsenio Hall, I guess he got a Netflix special, and he had a joke on there that was kind of funny, because he was like, have you ever, basically the phone is used to like communicate, call people and receive calls, but he was like, basically nowadays people get upset, he get upset when people call him on the phone. The purpose of the phone is to receive calls and make calls, but like I said, he like, it's his book reader, it's his books, or how he read books. He was like, it's his music players, so all these different things. So yeah, a phone functions in a multitude of ways, and that show you how Esau used, you know, it's called social engineering, you know what I mean? Just like with Facebook and whatnot, you know what I mean? People have an opportunity to actually speak to other people around the world, and people are so vain that they want to, you know, make the world, you know, you see them people that they got to tell you everything they doing for the fucking day. They got to put up there, I'm eating my banana pudding breakfast, or, you know what I mean? Like, you know what I mean? Like, oh, this is the outfit I'm wearing. You know, just superficial shit. You know what I mean? While right now you literally got, you know, I just did a video. You got people that starving, people that's, I mean, homelessness has actually picked up. You know, I was listening to the brother Itazawan from Men of Valor. He was saying, you know, all these things, you know, homelessness has increased. Drug addiction has increased. Domestic violence has increased. Violence has increased. You know, jobs that people once held actually aren't coming back. You know, I just read an article about that. You know, so you on one hand, you'll have them saying that, oh, yeah, you know, the job numbers, unemployment is down. But then, like I said, I just read something. It literally said that the numbers from prior to the pandemic are totally different. You know what I mean? I literally just applied for unemployment. And like I said, you know, they said based on all the fraud that happened last year, on top of the fact it's a record number of claims just last month. These are the things that aren't being spoken on, you know. Because, like I said, a lot of people are in a little bubble that the Lord is about to pop, for real. This is pretty much what the video showed. It says, it's like a check engine light, Hepburn added, noting that those with chips will get the signal, then self-administer a blood draw and test themselves on site. It says, meanwhile, Pentagon scientist Dr. Kayvon Mudgerad also highlighted that the military is developing one-size-fits-all vaccine for CV, saying that this is not science fiction, this is science fact. And then they keep on reiterating this isn't science fiction. So they letting you know that they about to do this. That's the purpose of that, you know what I mean? That's about the third time they done mentioned this is not science fiction, this is science fact. We have the tools, we have the technology to do this all right now, he said, explaining the goal is to inoculate people against potentially deadly viruses that have not even appeared yet. So why people thinking this is mandatory, if they talking about they about to have one for one shot kill all CV variants and everything, you really think they going to allow a person not to take that? You know, the whole thing right now is they talking about they done developed all this and now you got all these different variants. So that's a excuse to use why everybody must be inoculated, because if you have a certain section of the populace that doesn't want to get inoculated, but then, like I say, you know, and you heard what it said too. It's a lot here, not to digress, but it said a one-shot vaccine, because at the end of the day, you know, right now you got exemptions for maybe some people that's pregnant. There's certain exemptions in place, but eventually that's going, because they're trying to come up with certain vaccines that actually will be for a person that's pregnant, will be for a person that has existing preconditions and whatnot. You know what I mean? So, yeah, I mean, this is about to go down. You can watch the video interview below. And that was the point, you know. I'm going to reread it again. We have the tools, we have the technology to do this all right now, he said, explaining that the goal is to inoculate people against potentially deadly viruses that have not appeared yet. Killer Vs that we haven't seen or even imagined will be protected against, Mudgerad added. So, yeah. So I got one scripture and I'm going to end the lesson. This is the book of, the first scripture I brought out is talking about, you know, you know, the MOB. And this is the reward for actually accepting and getting it. Because, like I said, the MOB is an actual physical thing. It's not, you know, you have a spiritual mark and you have a physical mark. But the MOB is an actual physical thing. And like I said, it's beyond science fiction. Now, like I said, this is not far-fetched. It's not a conspiracy. I mean, I just played the video. Now, you're going to have some people that will believe the government even further. Like, oh, well, like they said, it's not to monitor you. Everything monitors you. It's cameras every fucking where. Your phone monitors you. You know, they say your TV has cameras in it. Your TV can monitor you. I mean, the brother Barack Allah, one of the heads out in L.A., he just did a video. They showing those robotic dogs. You know, they in New York. This is in China. This is in New York. They walk around with robotic dogs. You know what I mean? So, yeah. Who you think they're going to unleash them robotic dogs on? Revelation chapter 14, verse 9. And the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand, verse 10, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of Yahweh, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation. And he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. Meaning they're going to be bathed in that nuclear fire. So, I mean, you know, scripture tells us as if you, you know, believe, and if this doctrine resonates with you, you know, if you believe that you are an Israelite, you know, that you're not to take, you know, what scripture tells you, our laws say not to make any incisions in the flesh, not to cut into the flesh. But so we're not supposed to take, you know, the stab and jab, you know, because at the end of the day, it's a scripture I just brought out in Ecclesiasticus the other day about, you know, medicines was created from the earth, you know, and him and that is wise shall not abhor them. You know, with herbs and prayer, you know, I mean, you got brothers that's have ailments. That's part of being in this truth. You know, everybody got different lots, but you got brothers with ailments, and you know, the Lord sustains a lot of brothers. You know what I mean? But you know, Salakia, the point being. We all, you know, it talks about in the book of Revelations that we all will be presented with an hour of temptation. We all going to be presented with that choice. You're going to choose to accept this or you're going to choose to hold on to your faith, hold on to your faith, hold on to your integrity and basically stand as a believer of Yahweh B'Hashem Yahweh Shah. You know, so, you know, in that day, may Yahweh B'Hashem Yahweh Shah keep his faithful men. If you're a so-called Black, Hispanic, Native American, Seminole, Indian, West Indian, or Haitian, I implore you to come back to the laws, statutes, and commandments of Yahweh, B'Hashem, Yahweh Shah, or be destroyed. And with that, I want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Kol Haloyim, La Yahweh, B'Hashem, Yahweh Shah, B'Hashem, Rachakot, Espetam, double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, who rule well. Peace and salutations to the Akim, across the four corners of the earth, pushing this truth with faith and sincerity, and risking their lives as well as their freedom to do so. Shalom to the Akwath and the Akim out there listening and learning. Lord willingly, this was an edifying video. Shalom to the Israelite foreigners scattered abroad in the land of other nations, whom appear like the other nations, but subscribe to this truth. To you, I say shalom. Until next time, Lord willing, I'm able to come with another lesson. Shalom, shalom, and mawaf la baba. Shalom.